Dr. Mindy here, and on this video, I'm going to go through 7 different things you can do to prevent Alzheimer's and cognitive decline. And you can do these things today. In fact, some of them are going to be going in and looking at lab results that you may have gotten from your doctor. So I want to walk through some of those key markers that will really help you understand mental health and cognition at a deeper level. I think you'll see as I go through these 7 things that part of Alzheimer's, part of dementia, part of cognitive decline happens because our whole metabolic system gets turned all upside down. So I want to show you how to make that right again so that you can really keep your mind sharp. Okay, I have to remember them all. So I've written them all down here and I just want to go through them one by one, and I want to make sure you don't lose any of these 7 because they're all equally important. I did not put them in any specific order, so please listen all the way through. This is too important of a video. Too many people are getting Alzheimer's, too many people are suffering from dementia, and they don't know why. These are the 7 things you can do. First, I want you to look at hemoglobin A1C. So if you've gone, go get your lab work, if you have it from your doctor, I want you to look at the number of hemoglobin A1C. There are 2 reasons this is really vitally important. The first is hemoglobin A1C is an indication of what your glucose and insulin has been doing for 90 days. So in general, we say it's your insulin levels for 90 days, but in general, what I want you to remember is that hemoglobin A1C is telling you, are you moving towards insulin resistance? Are you already in insulin resistance? Or are you moving towards insulin sensitivity? So you want that number under 5. If it is over 5, you are moving towards insulin resistance. If it is under 5, you are insulin sensitive and you're moving more towards an insulin sensitive body, which is really important for the brain. Part of what I hope you know, but if you don't, I really want to point out that they're calling Alzheimer's type 3 diabetes. Because it is when our glucose and insulin system gets off, then all of that extra sugar starts to get stored in the brain and slows down the functionality of your brain, specifically an area called the hippocampus where Alzheimer's will start. So that hemoglobin A1C has to be that first thing you look at. Now, the other part of hemoglobin A1C is that it tells us how much oxygen is moving throughout your system. If your hemoglobin A1C is up around 6, 7, we know you are getting less oxygen to your tissues, specifically your brain. Without proper oxygenation of your brain, you are going to see these neurons start to die, and you're going to see this amyloid plaquing show up in the hippocampus. So that blood number is so important. So if either go look at what your test did the last time your doctor had it, or go get a hemoglobin A1C test. On my website, you can find an at-home kit if you haven't done one yet, but that is a critical number. Okay, number 2, that was all just the first tip. Number 2 is we have to remember that the brain has 2 fuel sources. One is glucose and one is ketones. So if you're not tapping into this fat-burning system, where you're getting ketones made from burning fat in your body and making ketones, you're literally depriving your brain of 50% of its preferred fuel source. That's crazy. Over time, if you don't feed the brain what it wants, that plaquing will appear and the neurons will start to degenerate. Ketones bring that neuronal health back and they start to supercharge your neurons. So make sure you're doing the metabolic switching that I've been teaching you all here, and that you're dipping into the fat burning energy system so that you can make ketones. That's number 2. And number 3 is also along those lines of something that I talk a lot about, which is we've got to bring our toxic load down. So it's funny because in our younger years, we don't really think about like the lotions we put on our face or the makeup we use or the hair products we use. We're so much more focused on beauty and making sure we look good. But in that, we often bring our toxic levels up. The problem with toxins is they start to decay the neurons in your brain. And they do it two ways. One is they will block the ends of the receptor sites of your neurons. So if you have endocrine disruptors at the end of a neuron, what's going to happen is the information is going to come across to the axon of the neuron. It'll go across the body of the neuron to the dendrites that carry that information out. And what will ultimately end up happening is if there are toxins there, the message stops. Now, what that looks like to you today is it looks like you walk into a room and you're like, why did I come here? What was I doing in this room? Or you're in the middle of a conversation with somebody and you say, what was I talking about? That is a classic indication of where a thought got stopped at the end of that neuron, and it's largely due to toxicity. So one of my favorite apps that you can all should be going to is Think Dirty app, and you can scan your beauty products, you can scan your household cleaners. Another app that I recommend a lot of my patients use is called Skin Deep. You can do the same thing. You can scan all of your products. You can also go to the Environmental Working Group's website, and they have a bunch of lists of household cleaners and sunscreens. But if you want to prevent Alzheimer's, you're going to need to get familiar with the toxins that are destroying the neurons in your brain. That's absolutely in the top recommendations that I have for you. Okay, number four, this is specific for women, but men, don't turn away because I still got three more great ones for you. But women, we have to learn to keep estrogen at its age-appropriate high. Part of what we know about estrogen is it's neuroprotective. There are several parts of our brain, including our prefrontal cortex, our hippocampus, the dorsal striatum in the deep parts of the brain, that really affect our cognitive abilities, and they are dense with estrogen receptor sites. So as we go through our menopausal years and we lose estrogen, we no longer have this precursor, this hormone nutrient for these parts of our brain to nourish our brain in order to allow decision-making to be effortless, to keep our cognitive, optimistic, can-do part of our brain up, and keep the memory and the moods and the hippocampus working at their best. Estrogen is a fuel source for these parts of the brain. So if you haven't looked at the Menopause Reset, the book I wrote, The Five Lifestyle Changes That Need to Occur After 40 Women, make sure you go and see that, get that book. We are reissuing it out into the world with a sleep chapter, but it is available for order right now on Amazon and Barnes & Noble and all the places where books are sold, so you can get it there. But there are five lifestyle changes that I definitely want you to make in order to keep your age-appropriate estrogen at its peak. Okay, number five. This is for both men and women. And it's a nutrient that is called BDNF. I like to think of BDNF as your fertilizer for your brain. And the reason that BDNF is so important is that it will supercharge and grow the neurons and allow you to keep that cognitive intelligence at its height. So think about this for a moment. You have trillions of these neurons going through, sending messages in your brain every second of your day. And if you don't use those neurons, you lose them. They start to wither away. Now we add in a high hemoglobin A1C, we add in low ketones, we add in a high toxic load, and you're going to lose those neurons very quickly. But one of the ways you can bring neurons back and even grow some new ones is through this Miracle-Gro nutrient called BDNF. And there's one way you get it. That's through HIIT training, where you are bringing your heart rate up high for about 45 seconds and then recovering for about 15 seconds and then bringing it back up high for 45. The classic HIIT training was done by a researcher in Japan called Tabatas. A lot of you might know Tabatas training was done 30 seconds on of a high intensity training, 30 seconds off where you're resting. That triggers, if the on is really, really intense and then you rest for 30 seconds, it will trigger BDNF. So make sure you're putting some of that HIIT training into your weekly or monthly workout routine. Okay, number six. Number six is really committing to quality sleep. There's a lot of ways you can do this. The first is you have to prioritize sleep. You ideally want to be in bed 2 to 3 hours after the sun comes down. That's going to when your brain and your body is going to start to repair. So make sure you're going to bed on time. Also make sure you're looking at things like the blue light exposure that you have before you go to bed, and make sure that you're engaging in more parasympathetic activities before you go to bed. I know in my house, when the sun sets, that's a sign to me to finish up my last meal and start to wind my brain down, knowing that in 2 to 3 hours after that moment, I've got to get into bed. So make sure that you're committing to sleep. The quality of sleep is massively important, maybe even more important than how much sleep you get. Although most experts would agree 7 to 9 hours a night is good sleep. It's work. It's just like working out. You got to really commit to that in order to get that kind of good sleep for yourself. Okay, and then the last one, and perhaps one of my favorite and becoming quickly one of my new favorites, is get yourself exposure to a hyperbaric oxygen chamber. This is massively important. I just got done doing a fundraiser on the power of for women with hyperbarics. Leanne Rimes and I did that together a couple weeks ago down in LA. But the reason that I was passionate about hyperbaric, Leanne's passionate about hyperbaric, is because we are seeing incredible evidence that when you bring oxygen into the neurons of the brain heals. So if you look at everything I just taught you, it's diet, it's toxic load, it's exercise, it's sleep, and you're doing that as foundational work for great cognitive health, and then you supercharge that with something like hyperbaric oxygen. You literally, what I just mapped out for you there is literally 7 ways you will never get Alzheimer's, you will never see cognitive decline. But if you have a loved one that's experiencing that, those are 7 amazing ways that you can start to implement now. And hyperbaric oxygen is an incredible tool. I will leave links for my favorite places to go and find resources to get hyperbaric oxygen in the notes here. So those of you that want to explore that have the opportunity to do so. But there's a lot you can do. You don't have to live with the diagnosis of Alzheimer's. Alzheimer's is happening more often to women than men. There's a large reason for that. That's another video. But I really want to make sure that we all stay healthy together. And those are my 7 things. Okay, if you've made it this far in the video, it's a sign. You definitely need to subscribe. If you love that video and you want to dive into more of the information I have on this channel, go to this video. On this video, I want to talk about the healthy foods that you might be eating that will stop you from a long and healthy life.